afternoon, South Africa, and a very warm welcome to you this gorgeous Wednesday afternoon. Happy hump day. Joburg is basically like melting. It's so warm. Cape Town is storming. We can't wait for summer to arrive because spring has officially sprung. Now, every generation, people that stand out in their respective craft are all over the place. Now, today on the show, we chat to multi-award-winning musician and producer Kabomo Vilakazi, who is regarded as South Africa's king of soul. Plus, we chat to Sabric CEO Kalyani Pillay, who will be explaining the importance of updating your FICA details and the importance of updating personal information to protect yourself and combat fraud. That's really important information for us to know. And of course, Donut and Baxter, our furry co-presenters, are in the loft, spreading some much-needed love and affection. And as we approach Heritage Day, we would like to know from you, who do you talk to when you want to learn more about your heritage? So get in touch with us on our social media platforms and tweet us at Afternoon Chat using the official hashtag Afternoon Express or comment on our Facebook page.
Hello, my name is Balisa Dembe, and as Jeannie said, happy hump day. But if it's hump day, you know what that means. We're one step closer to the weekend. And if you're proudly South African like I am, weekends equal braais. And what's a braai without a s'more? Now today we're making a delicious small pie braai. Braai pie, smai pie.
Small pie.
And that's helping me not only pronounce it, but to make it too, we've got the gorgeous Chef Clem. Hey Clem, happy Wednesday.
Happy Wednesday to you. Do we say like happy Wednesday? Happy every day.
Happy every happy day. Every day is an opportunity to celebrate. And today I'm celebrating the s'more.
It's naughty. It's got... Well, a braai pie, we've seen it's a savory thing that happens. Yes. We made it a bit sweet today with some marshmallows, toffee sauce, chocolate of a different kind. I'm going to tell you about that later. Okay. But then there's also, what do you know about falooda?
Nothing.
I'm going to educate you today on a falooda. It's delicious. It's great. You're going to love it. Yeah.
Perfect. Sounds like everything I need today. And I'm a bit of a savory girl, got a savory tooth, so I cannot wait to get into these sweet treats. I see we've got the puff pastry going on, the marshmallows going on, we've got the falooda going on.
I'm with you, I'm also quite a savory person, but you know what, today we're going to be happy. We're going to be happy.
So happy. Now, speaking of treats, our special guest today is Kabomo, who is known as one of the hardest working producers and singers in this country. And it doesn't stop there. The King of Soul also wears a hat of an actor and filmmaker. With already 5 albums under his belt, this multi-talented, soulful singer is currently in studio stewing up his latest music offering for the world, titled All Things Red. And because we're always ahead of the curve here on Afternoon Express, we will be giving you an exclusive performance from his latest album later on in the show. But first, here's a peek into one of the songs that solidified Kabomo's music ship.
In my people's quest for true freedom, I pray that we unmask ourselves from everything that allows us to love. Because love is true freedom. And that's where our freedom is.
Painting a picture with every word that I bring to you. Singing the color of you. Because you know this. Love in the music. Love is the message I bring to you. Is the color of you.
The day, it's a day, open your eyes so you can see.
Ladies and gentlemen, the sweet, soulful sounds of Kabomo. Welcome to the loft.
Thank you so much for having me, man.
So good to have you here. I mean, your music is just so sexy. It's easy to just, you can just listen to it any time of day and it immediately puts you in like a cool, chilled mode.
For sure. That's the intent. I'm glad you see it like that.
It's working. So before you did All Things Grey, which was an amazing success, you were already working and killing it in the music industry.
For sure.
What was your role? You were producing here for...
Yeah, I was producing, I was artist managing, I managed Flaba, who passed away from Squatter Camp, great artist. I was on the road with Tembisi out there. I was music directing for Onati. I was just busy with different musicians, writing, producing for Patep or Sola, like just from a range of hip-hop artists, pop artists, soul artists, jazz artists. I just liked being in the background and helping.
Yeah. So then what was that moment where you decided to cross over and do it for yourself?
I think that when you're born with a calling to be an artist, it's sort of like like eat you inside. I was very comfortable being like sort of like being behind the scenes, but that thing was always like nagging at me inside, and you can't ignore that thing forever. So eventually I had to just agree to whatever it was that was calling me, and I'm glad I did.
Well, you know, with Sia, she released her album because she had had all of these songs that other artists didn't want to sing, and then she put them all on an album. She did it on her own. And then it was, you know, every song was a hit.
For sure.
Was that a similar case with you when you did All Things Grey?
No, I don't think it was a song that people didn't want to use. I was lucky enough that all the songs that I sort of pitched to artists, like, they liked. And because I didn't have the pressure of being, like, a hit maker. Like, I whenever people would ask me to come work on an album, they already have like their hit producers who can make them the hit songs. I usually am the guy who comes in and sort of makes the album more fuller, more
Is
deeper.
Is that how
meaning.
It
yeah,
works?
Yeah. Well, for me, I'm very comfortable with that role. Yeah. I think everybody wants to compete as a songwriter, producer, to be the one that gives you the hit that's going to be on radio and TV. I'm comfortable being the guy who does the rest of the album.
Yeah.
The songs with more meaning, with deeper lyrics, with more heartfelt emotions to it. And I've always been a kind of a writer, producer, and I'm glad to be that.
Like, when you listen to songs and when you're putting together an album, do you know which songs are going to be the hit from the beginning?
No, you know, the thing is, some people claim they do, but it's a big lie because you can never sort of ascertain what your audience is at the same time. Yeah. When you make music, you make it from your perspective. But when the audience listen to it, they listen to it with their own stories, with their own feelings, with whatever they're dealing with. And you can never be able to sort of prophesy that thing. So there is no really a system or a way of figuring out what a hit is. Most people will tell you that the one song, like for instance, Color of You that you just played, it was the last song I put on the album. I wasn't even sure I wanted to put on the album because I didn't really see it as such as a big deal. And it became my biggest hit on the album. So you can never tell.
Yeah, what people are going to
know. Yeah, exactly.
Okay, so then when you did All Things Grey, you then started gigging it and touring it quite soon after it was released. And then it was just so well received.
It was. I was very lucky. And I don't take it for granted that there's like thousands and thousands of very talented artists in this country who put out albums that never really get any sort of like popularity or people get to listen to it. The fact that I put out my first album by myself as an independent artist and for it to blow up as it did and have so many number one hits coming from my first album and to still have a career all these years later with all the albums I've released since then, having like consistency, winning awards, touring, I don't take it for granted because I know many people do the same thing and don't get the opportunity to have the kind of success that I have.
Okay, but putting an album together and being in studio,
for sure,
that's your comfort zone.
Yes, it is.
But what happens when you've got to go on stage now and sing your own songs and have the crowd sing back your own words
for sure.
to you? It's incredibly
overwhelming because you don't know what kind of experiences people have with the music, and you'll go to certain spaces where a promoter will say people are not very familiar with the music, so don't take it too hard. And you go out to 10,000 people, and they sing your song from beginning to end.
That must be amazing.
And different kinds of races. I've sung to like white people, Indian people, Japanese, like, and people all over the world. People know my music. You know, I've got a great friend based in Asia. I don't even know how they get my music, but it's there, you know?
Yeah.
So I'm very appreciative of that.
That is fantastic.
Yeah.
What's been your favorite element of the music business so far?
You know, I'm a music fan.
What do you listen to?
I listen to everything from Brahe to Miles Davis to Robert Glasper to Brandy to Tandy Somers
Rye. You actually.
What's that?
You worked with Brahe just
before he
passed, actually.
I was very fortunate that it's probably a highlight of my career that just before he passed away, the last album that he released, he asked if he could collaborate with me. Which is a big deal.
He's
literally in my top five favorite artists of all time.
Yeah.
So to have him ask me to collaborate with him was a big deal. Then I asked him to be on the last album that I did, Unapologetic, and he came through and played his horn and sang and spent the day with me and spoke about his life and almost as if like he knew that he was about to go, because he said so many beautiful and positive things. And the responsibility that I have now is that I'm a growing artist, that I have to young artists, and in the same way that he was a mentor to me, was almost passing the mantle to saying, don't just make it about yourself. You're blessed to be a blessing to others. You know, like, make sure that you look out for other artists or young artists who look up to you.
There's so much to say for being a fan of the work that you do. Like, for example, as a TV presenter, I like to interview people that I'm a fan of.
For sure.
So it must be so awesome to work with people that you're a fan of in the music business.
Exactly.
As well.
I mean, that's like, as I was saying, for me,
the best thing. Actually.
Yeah, exactly. just to be able to be like backstage with your favorite artist, and you're just about to go on stage, and your favorite artist is standing right there, and or they come and say, "Oh, I love the song that you made." Yeah. For me, like, it's probably the biggest motivator as a music fan to be able to meet and collaborate and call people that I love my friends. You know,
exactly.
Yeah.
So All Things Grey is out, and now All Things Red.
Yes.
The latest offering. Yes. What does that sound like?
I'm very excited. So what happened is with my career that we had the success with this neo soul album called All Things Grey, but the country was sort of like not sure what it was because it was such like a new genre, and I got signed to other major labels, and I was sort of like sidetracked in trying different things, try house, try this, try hip hop.
Yeah, because you rap, you do
everything. Yeah, for sure. And I got caught up in all of that, but I missed doing what I do best, which is soul music.
Yeah.
So when I finally became an indie artist again, I was like, I want to go back to making music the way I did. And I wanted to have a continuation between All Things Grey and this album. But because I'm older, I understand passion better because it's an album about passion. And I think Red represents passion in such a huge spectrum, like from the beauty of roses as red to the tension of blood as red to the skyline as red. Like, Red for me represents passion in such extremities. Yeah. And that's the kind of like attitude that I went into making this music. It goes to very deep sentiments and it goes to very lighthearted sentiments, but all under this umbrella of passion.
Amazing.
And that's what All Things Red is about.
And we've got an exclusive. We're having you performing on the show as
well.
Yes,
I'm excited. I haven't performed anything from this album, so your audience will be hearing the first song ever by anybody from my album. I'm excited.
That's what we like. We like first times all here on Afternoon Express. Thank you so much for being here.
Thank you so much for having me.
No, you're a legend. Thank you. After the break, we head over to the kitchen with Chef Clem to make a s'mores braai pie using 5 super delicious ingredients. Trust me, it's the most delicious thing I've ever seen in my life. And let's just say it's going to be a very delicious, very sticky affair. And of course, later we chat with Sabric CEO Kalyani Pillay on the importance of taking note of communication from your bank and keeping your FICA status updated to avoid serious legal implications and complications. We'll see you after the break.
Molweni, South Africa. Heritage Day is upon us and your feel-good breakfast show will be bringing you the best in educational and cultural entertainment as we host isiXhosa language radio station Umhlobo Weneni TV meets radio to celebrate our diverse cultural landscape as well as learn more about the heritage of Tata Nelson Mandela in a centenary year. Catch EBEE Breakfast Show on Expresso on Monday the 24th of September. Heritage Day, 6 to 9 a.m. on SABC 3. The stage is yours.
Welcome back to Afternoon Express on SABC3, where the stage is yours. Now, you must have heard of s'mores, and you've heard of the braai pie. But have you heard of a s'mores braai pie? Well, today, we're creating something by combining the two, creating a decadent braai dessert made with only 5 ingredients. Mm-hmm. Clem, we're not the only chocolate treats in the kitchen today.
Oh, I like that. Ooh. No, we're not. So we're actually using something that's quite new. I'm going to pick it up. Mm. So this is the new chocolate coconut creme dessert. It's dairy-free because we make a coconut oil.
Wow.
It's delicious. It's like super decadent. The way that it melts in your mouth. The first time I ate it, I cried. Okay? I cried.
Tears came out.
It's so good.
Believable, because that sounds so delicious to me.
Crazy decadent. So that's new from Woolies now. Check it out on shelf. You also get the Granadella one, which is also like really good. But the chocolate.
Yeah, I'm a chocolate queen.
There we go.
Yeah.
So first things first, all butter puff pastry. There's a difference between the all butter puff pastry and the normal one.
Okay.
Okay. And it's in the title. It's made out of all butter. So it's super decadent, super rich, but it makes this pie what it is.
Ooh,
so
yum.
To this, we're gonna add a mixture of marshmallows. Toasted coconut marshmallows.
Okay.
Yeah, I love them. They are like absolutely my favorite. When I was younger growing up, I didn't like them at all.
I was going to say, I saw that someone took a little bit of a nibble.
Did you see that?
Out of our darling marshmallows. And
Who did that? And
the person wants to be busted because, I mean, that's loud and proud.
Because you know what also, right? When I mentioned it, Jeannie's back was like, facing me. Before I even say what happened, she was like, wasn't me.
I think I know who the culprit is, yeah. I'm just saying.
Yeah, I think so too. Got these giant braai marshmallows as well. Get those in Woolies.
Yum.
They are just so much fun. Get that on there.
Yeah, so you can also just put those on your skewers if you just want to go straight in.
Straight in, absolutely. Definitely.
And toast that bad boy.
Definitely. Then I got my toffee dessert sauce, okay? Super delicious.
Oh, yum. Clem, just all I'm thinking right now is that when you break into that small, all the yummy juiciness and goodness of everything that's packed inside will just come spewing out.
It does just come out. I think that's enough. There we go.
Yeah, that's enough.
Like that. Then you take a second sheet, you get 2 sheets in a box.
Okay.
Just slide it out just like there.
Okay.
Then use the plastic that it comes with as well.
I see it already has some flour on top.
Yeah, just to help you so it's not too sticky.
Okay, yeah,
got you. There we go. Do that, and then you carefully just kind of peel away the sides of the plastic, and then it comes off. It takes a little bit of practice to get it all off, but basically the plastic helps you just keep everything together. The plastic is your friend. You can see that it's coming off just like that. Keep on working it all the way to the end, and then pop it either on a braai grid, pop it in the oven, and it comes out looking like this.
Ooh,
but where's the chocolate? We haven't used the chocolate yet.
Yeah,
that goes on top.
Okay, I see what you did. I thought that the brown is the chocolate, but I guess
You can put some on the inside as well. Okay. Like we did a little bit here. So check it out. But do you want to grab that spoon for me? Just please taste this.
Happily.
And then all you do is just kind of smear it over the top.
I would never say that there was no dairy in this.
I know. It's so creamy.
It's so creamy. It is so good. Honestly, this is what I'm having this weekend. Oh, what a nice treat.
Cut it into portions, or you know what? Get angry at it, just you and the thing is by itself like that, and that's that.
And there crush it up. Delicious.
Easy. You wanna do like a little bit of a chubby bunny challenge?
No, I can't, because I have to deliver a link and everyone wants to know how to get this recipe, so you will not do that to me. But you're more than welcome to stuff it in. You have to present the rest of the show exactly like that, Clem.
I can't again.
Whilst Clem is struggling with those marshmallows, you have to try this. And to get the recipe, simply SMS EAT to 33650 to get the ingredients list and link to the recipe. And just in case you missed any of the steps, check out the quick recap. I told you that thing was delicious. Oh, I'm salivating already for it. Now, when moving houses, offices, or changing cell phone numbers, the last thing on your mind is to update your FICA details. But did you know that failing to do this could result in serious legal implications? We have SABRIC CEO, my beautiful friend, Kalyani Pillay in the loft, to explain the importance of knowing your customer for banks and businesses and just how important updating personal information can be to protect yourself and combat fraud. Thank you so much for being here in the
Thank loft. Thank you, Jeannie. It's always great to be here. Yeah.
So what exactly is FICA? Because I remember a couple of years ago, we all had to go to the banks and we all had to provide information of where we live and who we are and give them every little detail about ourselves. Why did we need to do that? What does it mean?
Well, look, you know, government has introduced FICA, the Financial Intelligence Center Act, as a means to combat financial crimes like money laundering, terrorist financing, tax evasion, and of course also to protect bank customers who become victims of fraud and all kinds of bank-related crime. And as part of all of this, banks and other financial institutions have to obtain and keep identity information of the of their customers.
Yeah.
They also don't, they're not supposed to just get this once off. They're supposed to ensure that they keep that information updated all the time. It needs to be current and relevant information about the identity of their customer, where their customers reside, so you need proof of address as well. And all of this, amongst other information, is important because it helps banks know exactly who they're dealing with. And of course, protects you against anybody, if we're looking at it in the context of banking, it protects you from having anybody else come and take over your account, somebody who would steal your identity. So it's all part of that. But there's so many other components to it. Because not only do banks have to ensure that they know their customers' identity, but they also have to have the right to inquire from a bank customer as to where they are obtaining those particular funds from. In other words, to understand the source of the funds. And also, to go beyond that, the banks also have to know their client to the extent of knowing what their business relationships are. And these are the kind of things that enable banks to look at the behavior of a particular bank account to see if there's something suspicious that's happening. And in that way, they're able to detect fraud. They're able to look at crime prevention. I'm sure, I don't know whether you would ever have had this experience, and I'm sure a number of the viewers actually would have, where you'd get a call from your bank and they would say, you know, I'm just calling to find out whether it is you that's actually doing this transaction.
It is me trying to do the transaction. I was actually laughing. I was in New York and I was trying to do some shopping and my bank didn't allow the transaction to go through. And I said, you know, my banking security is so good, not even I can use it.
I think it's part of the things that when they pick up an unusual spend in another country and you haven't notified your bank that you're going to be traveling, you know, it's always good to do that. You'd rather have that call as opposed to having monies taken out of your account fraudulently and then to get it back is always a problem.
But it does seem that South Africa's banking and our security systems are really, really good.
They certainly are.
Absolutely.
We certainly are at the top, you know.
Yeah. What kind of risks can we be at, I suppose, if we don't have FICA? And especially if our details aren't up to date.
Well, look, for one, it's legal compliance. You know, so the banks actually are forced to because it's an act. And like I said, it's not a once-off thing. So bank customers, I think from our side as bank customers, we should always make sure that when we call, when we get a communication from our bank saying, look, you need to come in, you need to update your details. People change addresses, they move to different places, they change jobs. You need to always make sure that they have your latest salary advice or your income or balance sheet, that kind of thing. So I think it's a two-way thing. It's about the banks complying with the act. It's about us as citizens and customers making sure that we enable that because we're also helping to protect ourselves.
Exactly.
So you know, I mean, I know it's an inconvenience to have to go into the bank, but one of the things that's really important is that the criminals also use this to their own advantage. You may receive a communication saying, this is your bank, we need to update your details, please send us this by mail or we'll call you. Don't provide it. You've got to go into the bank and provide the documents, you know, yourself in person.
Exactly.
And if you can't do it, then of course the bank does have another mechanism, but you've got to check with your bank first.
It is a bit of a schlep, but I mean, once it's done, because you need to be FICA registered and compliant to also get cell phone contracts and to get all of that done. And remember, a couple of years ago, if you didn't have your FICA done, then your bank account would get frozen.
Well, you know, banks actually have to take quite stringent measures against anybody who doesn't want to comply.
Yeah.
In fact, if they don't ensure that they do that, then they get a fine. So so if a bank customer is failing to go into the bank and to have themselves FICA'd, then the bank has no alternative, but they do it as a last resort to actually freeze that particular bank account.
What do we need to take into the bank with us to get our to get ourselves FICA'd?
Well, you know, depending on the kind of client that you are and the kind of how you receive your income, but most often it's your identity document that needs to be taken in with a photograph. Of course, in South Africa, we do also have the a relationship with the Department of Home Affairs that allows electronic authentication or verification of a person's identity. Okay. Then you need to take proof of your residence. That's what the utilities bill is what you can go with. You need to have proof of income. And of course, if you're acting on behalf of somebody who's out of the country to bring that in, you need a letter of authority.
Okay.
But the bank is very, they'll be very helpful and they'll actually let you know before you go in if you're not certain as to what documents you should take.
Okay, wonderful. Yes. Thank you so much.
It's a pleasure.
I'm going to phone my bank and see if I'm FICA compliant.
You better.
Now, what would you do if you received a phone call, SMS or email requesting confidential information? There's only one right answer. Do not respond and contact your bank. So join us next week where Kalyani explains how to hashtag wise up and avoid phishing, vishing and smishing so you don't become another statistic.
We are brave, innovative, everywhere. We are Sabrek.
Now, after the break, we're back in the kitchen making a creamy and aromatic Nolac falooda, a drink that has become part of our South African heritage. Remember to engage with us on social media and tell us who do you talk to when you want to learn more about your heritage. Tweet us at Afternoon Chat using the official hashtag Afternoon Express or comment on our Facebook page. See you after the break, darling.
Winner Home, South Africa's premier design and decor reality show, is back. And this year, we're coming to you from the breathtaking Pardeflay Lifestyle Estate in Somerset West, developed by Baldwin Properties. Follow three talented design duos as they transform three white box penthouse apartments into fully decorated luxury homes, one of which you could win.
My name is Koketo Marole.
My name is Rekupile Belebesi.
She saw me, I saw her.
Together.
Magic.
Now we're here.
Magic.
My name is Nicholas Smith.
My name is Kihumile Mate.
We're not here to play games.
No games to play here. 150% or nothing.
My name is Sinead Turner.
I'm Melissa Westhazen.
We're so excited to showcase what we're capable of. So stay tuned.
Watch the beautiful properties come to life as the design drama unfolds and stand a chance to win the biggest prize on South African television, your very own dream home. Catch Winner Home from Thursday, 20 September at 7:30 p.m. only on SABC 3. The stage is yours. Winner Home, proudly brought to you by Capitec and Private Property. Grand prize luxury penthouse apartment by Baldwin Properties.
Kava Nolac, lactose-free milk that lets you enjoy dairy again. Made with love by Clover.
Welcome back to Afternoon Express. Now, the origins of falooda dates back to Persia and India, but because of its creamy and aromatic rose syrup taste, there's no surprise why this international drink became part of South African heritage. So, made with clover Nolac, this easy-to-make recipe is one to enjoy so much, even if you are lactose intolerant. So, to get your hands on this recipe, SMS the keyword clover to 33650. SMSs cost R1.50 each, and no free SMSs apply. This looks delicious, Clem.
I think it's one of my favorite drinks. It's just, there's so much that goes into it.
I've never had a falooda before.
And when you make it right, it's a very beautiful thing.
Okay.
It really is. Because, I mean, rose syrup can be very strong, but the way that they use it now is perfectly balanced.
But does it have that rose taste?
Yes.
Because that's what, I love that.
And it hits you, and they even decorate it with rose petals.
Oh, I'm obsessed.
It is.
But now this confuses me. You've got noodles
okay,
there.
Okay, I'm going to tell you all about it.
Clearly, so, I've never had a falooda.
So, you know, okay. The Persians were very extravagant, right?
Yeah.
Everything beautiful, everything perfumed. They even used gold leaf, apparently, to decorate the drinks back in the day.
I mean, I was Persian in a past life.
Must be. But I mean, I love the fact that it's part of South African history now. It really is. Okay, clover Nolac going in the bowl, and then I'm adding my chia seeds. You know what? You tell me why I'm adding it to the dish.
Okay, and this is important for all of our viewers to know. Your chia seeds have to be activated before you eat them, because they swell. Hey, when you put them with water, they actually swell. And if you don't let them swell before you eat them, then they swell down your digestive tract and they get stuck in your colon and your intestines.
That's why.
You don't want that.
That's why.
You want them swollen.
You want them swollen, just like that. Cool. Then, after about, I'd say, an hour, they've swollen up nicely. You can kind of see it's a bit gelatinous, which is what you want. Yeah. It's a very thick drink. So now let's just start building this guy. Cool. To this, I'm going to add this vermicelli noodles.
Why the vermicelli noodles? I don't understand it.
I think it's just about the texture that you get from it, to be honest with you.
So it's quite slurpy.
It is. But it's a drink that's going to keep you going for a while.
Okay.
It's, I love the texture. It's almost like a booba type drink. Everybody's like, booba? Okay, now they get it.
What's a booba drink?
Booba's also got like...
What is booba?
Booba is also made with type of vermicelli noodles.
Okay.
And then, yeah, it's kind of baked like with a custard.
Okay. Yeah. Oh,
we should have done booba.
Let's have a booba next time.
Let's do booba next time.
Okay.
Then there you go with a little bit of rose syrup. This is quite sweet. And you got to do the pink one.
Yeah.
Don't get the one that does the clear one. Make it pink.
Can I smell it?
Oh, it smells full on like...
Oh, that is so beautiful.
Drizzle.
Yeah, so
I was going to say, if you want it very sweet, again, Persians like their sweet drinks, add a bit of honey to it. I think we're fine. I think we're okay. Then we pour in our beautiful soaked chia seeds.
Yeah. And of course, this is lactose free as well.
Ooh, trust me to miss. Guys, you know, I'm a lefty. Why am I pouring with my right hand? There we go.
There
it's lactose free, exactly. And let's get just like that. Just
there
to remind everyone at home, our straws are from their bamboo and their glass, by the way.
So, you know, no plastic straws should be used ever nowadays. So, I'm going to take, should we have the glass ones or the bamboo ones?
I like the bamboo. But we're not done yet. Then, to this, we're going to add. So I've taken some coconut cream, whipped it slightly, and then frozen it. Because we can't have cream, right? It's lactose free.
Okay.
So in we go with the coconut. And I feel like the coconut does add like quite a nice flavor to it as well. Don't leave it in the freezer for too long, guys.
I bought coconut milk, and when I opened it in the tin, it was hard like that.
Yeah, that's a good thing.
Is that a good thing?
That's kind of just the coconut fat that's separated from the coconut milk.
Okay.
Yeah, this is frozen.
Okay, but why does the coconut, because I thought it's supposed to be milky and then it was all hard.
Yeah, it's just because of the density between the liquid and the fat.
Oh.
So the fat always rises to the top.
Should I just shake it?
Give it a good shake and then you'll be fine. Okay, cool. We're almost done. Almost done. Let me just get this all clean. Guys, my mom's like, this guy's cooking like he does at home. I don't know if my mom just saying, she knows, she remembers. Then to this, a few rose petals.
Okay.
Because we have to be pretty about it.
Yeah.
And then we've got some pistachio nuts.
Beautiful. Oh, this is gorgeous.
It really does
look like that beautiful Indian kind of drink.
And a few dehydrated ones, rose petals as well.
Oh, so decadent.
And then do you want an extra rose syrup?
Yeah, why not? The sweeter the better.
There we go.
Sure, Clem.
It's a bit fancy, eh?
Yeah, I love fancy. Okay, are we ready to taste?
Let's go.
Okay. But should we mix it in?
You have to give it a mix.
Okay, I'm so excited. What's it called again? A falooda.
Falooda.
This is my first falooda. Oh, this is great.
Mm. Not too sweet as well.
Mm. No, this is perfect. It's not too sweet at all. I wouldn't add the honey. Mm. But I don't like too sweet.
Mm.
You've got to get you guys a falooda. Creamy, sweet, and tasty. What's not to love? Now, remember, SMS the keyword clover to 33650 to get this recipe sent directly to your device. SMS is R1.50 each, and free SMSs don't apply. And if you need to see how this is made one more time, watch this. Mmm. Delicious, can't wait for that falooda a little later. Now, if you are wondering how you can provide a comfortable lifestyle for your furry friend, stay right there. After the break, Dr. Stefan Smith from Tigerberg Animal Hospital has all the tips to help us improve the lives of our furry companions.
Clover Nolac, lactose-free milk that lets you enjoy dairy again. Made with love by Clover.
Get ready. The face of cybercrime is changing. And so are we. We are smarter. We take charge. We are in control. We are brave, innovative, everywhere. We are Sabrek.
Whiskas, feed their curiosity.
Welcome back to Afternoon Express. Now, we spend a lot of time thinking about how to improve our own lives, but have you ever thought about how you can improve your pet's life? Today, we are talking about how to ensure that your pets lead a comfortable lifestyle with Dr. Stephen Smith from Tigerberg Animal Hospital. Welcome to the show.
Thanks very much, Jeannie.
So we've obviously got Baxter and Donut that I think lead very comfortable lives.
Looks like it. I can see them around the
studio. They are incredibly pampered pets. But I think if you look at families that maybe are looking to get a pet, that haven't had pets before, what are the most important things to remember before getting a pet and bringing a pet into your home?
I suppose there are a few things to consider. One is the affordability.
These days, it can get quite expensive to keep pets, especially if they get ill. They need to be fed, they need to be vaccinated, they need to be sterilized. You know, certainly don't get 10 if you can only afford two, you know, that sort of thing. So basically your resources, and included in that would be your space. You know, an energetic large breed dog needs a large garden. You need time, you need to take them for walks and exercise them. Small toy breeds will need to be brushed and groomed. So, you know, Persian cats, that sort of thing, they need a lot of time and effort to put in. And if you're away from home, if your lifestyle doesn't really fit in with daily exercising and that sort of thing, you know, maybe you need to consider a cat who can quite happily spend a bit of time by himself every day, knowing that he'll get a bit of love in the evenings, you know, that sort of thing.
That was my problem. I had ordered a dog and I couldn't wait to get this beautiful puppy. But I travel too much and I work too much, so I'm never going to be at home with this dog. So I thought it would be too unfair, which is so sad because all I want is a dog.
That's absolutely. Look, these days there are facilities, doggy daycares, for example, but certainly that's more for a day-to-day thing, not if you're away for a week at a time, you know, that sort of,
I think if you live in an apartment, it's a good idea to have a cat. But what about apartments or small spaces and dogs? Dogs need gardens, hey?
Well, yes and no. It depends on what breed you get. You know, ironically, sometimes a huge dog like a St. Bernard actually has more need of less need of exercise than maybe a Border Collie, for example. So, you know, those sorts of things. But, you know, overseas, in South Africa, we're obviously very fortunate. We've got a lot of sunshine, we've got a lot of gardens. But overseas, they do this really well. You know, in cities around the world, you'll see people walking big dogs and you look around and you see where these are.
Well, the Great Danes are known as apartment dogs.
Exactly. But again, those are walked every day. You know, overseas, they'll have professional dog walkers, that sort of thing. So you can do it. You've just got to know, you've got to invest some time and effort into making sure they get the exercise, they get the attention that they need. And then a lot of the time, they actually just flop around and laze all day. So they're actually fine.
One thing that I did notice, living in Cape Town, especially during the cold and wet weather, is a lot of people sometimes leave their dogs outside. Yeah. And I understand they may be guard dogs, but surely dogs should be kept inside or have their own enclosures where they can be protected from the cold and bad weather. Yeah.
That is a very important point. You know, they do have some basic needs. And forget about them. It's just the dog that can stay outside.
Yeah.
They do need a warm, dry shelter. It doesn't necessarily have to be inside, although that is preferable.
Yeah.
But some people just don't have that facility. So if there are plenty of warm kennels, you can certainly zhuzh up a kennel a little bit if you like and put a decent bed in there, as long as they don't get wet, because wet and cold is dangerous. They can get ill like that,
Because I know a lot of people panic about having dogs in their beds or on their furniture at home. But you can certainly make a little area.
Absolutely. And everybody must make his or her own decision as to where to allow the pet, of course. So, you know, some people will not allow them past the kitchen door into the rest of the house. They're allowed to sleep in the kitchen. Other people, they sleep here on the pillow next to mommy's, you know, head every night.
Yeah.
So, which is all fine, but pets are very intelligent. They know, as long as they've got boundaries, you know, they're like children, actually. They need their boundaries, then they feel safe and secure. And if you're a good, strong leader, then they certainly feel safe. They know where they're allowed to go, where they're not allowed to go, and they listen. They really do.
Now, grooming and taking care of your pets is also very important. So they all need to be brushed. They need to be taken to the parlor for good washes, or just bathed or showered at home. But also, do you need to brush a dog's teeth? I heard that you have to brush a dog's teeth. Is that true?
That is a very good point. Certainly on a daily basis in the veterinary clinic, we see dogs with terrible teeth. And just like us, they build up tartar plaque on their teeth, which then calcifies to form tartar.
Yeah.
So we brush our teeth twice a day at least, and we still go to the dentist six monthly or yearly. And we expect our dogs just to carry on like they are. It's very important for their health, actually, because bacteria and toxins can enter into the bloodstream through the gum and can affect the organs and especially kidneys. We think a lot of older animals with kidney failure, a lot of that's associated with teeth. And then with gum and bone loss in the mouth, that causes quite a lot of pain as well. Certainly do brushing. It does take a little bit of time and effort to get them into it. Yeah. Sometimes you need to take months to get them used to the idea.
Maybe if you start them as a puppy.
Absolutely. You need to do it from young. And in fact, the moment you buy a puppy, you need to be fiddling in their mouths every day, letting them get used to the idea that you're looking there. And then you start letting them lick the special tube. But you can avoid most of that as well.
Yeah. So. Thank you so much for preparing me for puppy motherhood.
Well, good luck with that. Let me know if you have any problems.
I will do. Now, just as we do with Donut and Baxter, make sure that you are doing everything that you can do to ensure that your pet leads a comfortable lifestyle. In the end, their happiness will also benefit you.
They're cute, they're cuddly, and they're TV stars. Baxter and Donut, the adorably fluffy four-legged members of the Afternoon Express family, are sharing their daily adventures on social media. To see what Baxter and Donut get up to behind the scenes, follow the Adventures of Baxter and the Adventures of Donut on Instagram.
Now, all this talk of companionship has me in the mood for some soul music. So after the break, Kabomo gives us an exclusive performance of his latest album, All Things Red.
Hey, babes.
One, two, one, two.
Welcome back to Afternoon Express on SABC 3, where the stage is yours. I'm standing next to the King of Soul, Mr. Kabomo himself. You have this amazing song coming off of your latest album, All Things Red. It's titled Celebrity.
For sure.
I'm very interested. What does the song mean?
Well, it's just likening that somebody you're with, like your celebrity, that you should treat your girlfriend, you should treat your wife as if they're a celebrity at home.
Oh, that's so stunning.
Yeah.
But I hope that celebrity status isn't the be all and end
oh,
all.
Oh, no. I mean, my wife is like 10 times more than any celebrity I've met, you see?
Your wife is a queen.
Yeah.
And she is certainly handling the King of Soul himself. Now, for a while, fans all over the country have been begging Kabomo for a new album. He has finally answered the call and is about to release what he deems as the best album he's ever done, All Things Red. The album will feature some of Mzansi's best artists, and we're delighted to be the first ones to get a taste of his latest work. Ladies and gentlemen, we present you with the King of Soul, Kabomo, performing his latest song, Celebrity. Take it away.
Thank you.
Enjoy.
The queen, like, do you sing to her in the kitchen when you're cooking her delicious
dishes? That thing gets
dishes?
Boring very quickly. You know how people say, I want a man who sings all the time?
Yes.
It's cute for like the first 3 days. Then the next 5 years, like, they're like, oh, can you shut up, please?
Did you guys sing at the wedding? Did you sing at the wedding?
No, we haven't yet. We just did the ceremonies and everything, so we're still gonna do like a big wedding.
Please. Oh, really?
And I'm getting all my friends to come from Afro Traction to Brian Tamba. If you sing, my wedding is gonna be like the biggest concert the country's ever had.
I absolutely.
Oh. Yeah.
I have to stalk you on social media.
Please, can we film it?
You guys come through. I'm inviting everybody.
Yay.
Score. Ideal. Amazing. Thank you
this
so
is
much.
Terrible to have in front of a big guy like myself. You know what I mean? Like,
I
this
mean,
is.
No, listen, this is.
Yeah. Listen, we had a phone call with your wife and she told us what to feed you just to keep you happy.
Yeah, pass me your plate. I'm actually going to give you a slice. I was busy having a chat to Valesa saying, I was asking her if she could have a good go with one of these slices.
Yeah.
If she,
I would definitely give a chance.
Yeah, I mean, we're going to try. Join us again tomorrow for your dose of Fashion Express Thursdays as Perseus Streetwear showcases their latest gear. Plus, folk singer Josia performs live in the loft. Thank you so much for joining us. We'll see you again tomorrow. Goodbye. God bless. Ciao. Okay, now I do you.
Love by Clover. Another feel-good production.